talk. We don't care who likes it or not, as long as we know it's the truth. Much of what I say might sound bitter, but it's the truth. Much of what I say might sound like it's stirring up trouble, but it's the truth. Much of what I say might sound like it is hate, but it's the truth. And God has mentioned in the Bible, it's the truth alone today that'll make you free. If you're afraid to tell the truth, why, you don't even deserve freedom. Just tell the truth. All you need is the truth. They put you in jail for carrying a plate, but they can't put you in jail for telling the truth.
Like life's walls are closing in on me. This world put its spin on me. I got a 2-ton jacket of sin on me. No hope, just doubt, a race to get out. Nothing to joke about. We live in the actual time that the prophet spoke about. My view on life and my perspective is that when things are hectic, God is not the first option selected, nor the second. Got a million drugs to stop the pain with, and Satan came with awkward language. Now he's shocked and anguished, hoping that the rock could change it. My tainted mind is dizzy, yeah. And now it seems like every time I need a sign, where is he? Call God, but his line was busy. We in and out of prison, trying to make our living in an unforgiving system that's money and power driven. The condition seems immutable, a plethora of wakes and funerals. The frequency of the youth's mind is untuneable, and truth and falsehood never coincided, just collided. How can the devil save your home when his own house is divided?
The world is coming to an end. It is never coming back again. God is your only friend. Without him, you can never win.
How can I pledge allegiance with wretched thieves and deviants when all my people ever received was deep grieving and deadly disagreements? Strategic deceiving. Now you expect me to stand and believe in an anthem Francis Scott Key penned back in 1814 when black people were being held in bondage. Ways of despicable disgust. Yeah. So those words were not applicable to us. You got the hell beat out you right after you served and fought war. So why you facing the flag with your hand pressed against your heart for? Don't be misled. See, the red represents oceans of bloodshed from the millions they murdered and left dead with no sympathy or leniency. The second color up in that flag represents the wicked premise of white supremacy. We live under a sick direction, just like the sky falsely appears to the eye. The color blue represents deception. So now's the time for resurrection. If you can't see America falling right in front of you, then you need an eye inspection.
The world is coming to an end. It is never coming back again. God is your only friend. Without him, you can never win.
Tell me how we gon' survive today. If you don't eat $10 worth of gas, won't get you out the gas station driveway. The words that Satan spoke were fraud. Instead of trying to choose between Republicans and Democrats, we need to vote for God and ride for him exclusively. I understand now what my elders meant when they say things ain't how they used to be. We cried until our eyes were red. The crazy part is that how bad it is now ain't even worse than what lies ahead. God lifted his hand to summon pestilence in the land is slumming. No respect between man and woman. Storms, earthquakes, and famine coming. People suffering and grieving a lot. Wicked shepherds deceiving the flock. Receiving a shock of the hour. It's hard to believe it or not. It's a key to the lock. See the state the economy in. Soon the food supply gonna be thin. Honestly, men are out here trying to be women now, and women wanna be men. Child molested and prostitution, multiple drug use and water pollution, educational system losing, watch the news, it's mass confusion.
The world is coming to an end. It is never coming back again. God is your only friend. Without him, you can never win.
On a rally a couple of weeks ago, the worst housing conditions in every city in America always exist in the so-called Negro community. And as I mentioned that on a rally a couple of weeks ago, the worst housing conditions in every city in America always exist in the so-called Negro community. And as I mentioned that on a rally a couple of weeks ago, the worst housing conditions in every city in America always exist in the so-called our rally a couple of weeks ago, the worst housing conditions in every city in America always exist in the so-called Negro community.